Good evening all, welcome to the Meitheal Ceol online daily sing-song for the soul from here in Wild West Donegal on the Wild Atlantic Way from Gweedore from Meitheal Ceol.
Good evening all.
You're welcome once again. It's Friday.
It might be a Friday, but it's actually Monday today.
Monday the 20th of April. 2020 COVID time. So I'd say hope you're ready for another set of songs again this evening, whoever's here. Again, if you're a first time venturer into this sing song, you're welcome. And so Meitheal Ceol is just an exercise in a group of people. Typically we'd have sung together around a table on a Wednesday night down in the men's shed, Skubal, Navarre, down in the shed in Gweedore. Men and women get together, sit around, we choose songs out of our two songbooks, and then everybody just sings and plays together. Just for a bit of crack, a bit of diversion, lifting the soul, etc. So in this time of incarceration, we're trying to transfer that experience as best we can online. And so that's what we're doing. So Mary has set out, if you hear every night, Mary here beside me sets out.
Hello.
And picks out a number of songs, gives some guidelines that we're going to cover. So tonight we have songs including My Forever Friend, Spancil Hill, The Irish Rover, The Massacre of Glencoe, Two Sisters, Travelling People, Love's Been Good to Me, Patrick Was a Gentleman. And of course then at 7:30, we'll be doing the three songs that we're going to repeatedly do for a number of nights to give us a chance to learn the songs and for people that sing along. And again, what this is all about is the singing. So how have we got it? We got a signal?
Yeah, I got a thing there.
So again, just want to confirm that we're streaming at the moment.
Can't hear anything here yet.
So so we're live, all right, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah. So again, to give Mary some, and we have some, with John Coyle, I think, in with us, which is good, yeah? So hi from Sunny Scary's Ray McCarthy. And Mary's just catching up with her
on the phone there.
And again, looks like it's been a lovely evening throughout. Ray, hi, in the middle of Ulster there. I hope your weather's quite good with you again this evening. And Nigel O'Mahony, yeah, lovely evening again, bit breezy, plenty of sun. So it was lovely again here today. I, looking at the app that I use, YR, seemed to be nice throughout the country. But and there was an east wind for us today while we were down on the shore. But so we also had I just see a post from Fergus Toohey, while we're just getting ready to get started there. Fergus sent in lovely little picture there. So it's not a gorgeous sight there from Drummond Town, so I presume that's the
retreat centre.
The retreat centre in Drummond Town, and if I'm not wrong, that's all those beautiful cherry blossoms. I've two cherry blossoms in my house in Dundalk, and they come out once or twice a year, I think, and for those couple of days, they're absolutely just gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Lovely serene looking lake, and weather, nice weather there with you there today, Fergus. So again, so if you want anybody, I just thought of this, that if you put up Facebook photographs of things, like, you know, as part of the sharing of what we're at, it would be nice to share that that experience of various things. Again, for us today, and we're going to sing a song in a moment, don't worry. We can just pick out these.
I don't know what's going on
so here. Mary's still having a bit of a problem trying to get a signal. Just so the other photograph that I thought was, I hope you like this photograph here today. I call that one there social distancing. They're like Diego and Mary there standing aside from each other, but not a sinner, not a soul on the beautiful beach in Port Arthur Beach in West Donegal. And you know, even in all the good times when nobody had to stay away from each other, the one wonderful thing about West Donegal is no matter how good the weather is, it's too far away from anywhere to be crowded like a lot of other beaches are. So hi, Ray Byrne. I hope life is nice over in Cooley as well.
Just
so, as again, we're
dear.
So what do we just say? Right, Mary seems to have a bit of a problem, so I don't know where you're in.
I don't know.
Well, first of you better Meitheal just Ceol. Go for Meitheal Ceol.
That's what I do, numbers of times. And
so the first song we're going to sing, guys, is...
My Forever Friend, is it?
Yeah, we're going to sing My Forever Friend, so for some reason
that's
or other...
That's Charlie Lonsborough. Charlie is from... Many people think that Charlie is Irish. In fact, he's not. Although his songs are very popular here in this country.
Hiya, Fergus, to you, by the way. So just trying to get the volume off. So look, let's kick in with My Forever Friend here. Start off and see how we get on. Some lovely songs I hope to share tonight.
Paul and again,
lovely sentiments in the song. And again, if you're new here, the whole thing is to join in whatever way you can, whether you're singing or playing an instrument or whatever, doing harmonies, whatever. Everybody's, we're just delighted to, for ourselves, just raise their spirits. Nice day today, raise your spirits anyway. It's nice to be able to share that as well.
Hello, Mary O'Gogan, how are you? You're welcome here this evening. We've missed you for a few evenings. We've got Ray McCarthy, you said, Paul Halton, taking a break from the garden for a while.
All right, so let's kick in here. And so we're playing this open. All right, everybody? Everybody needs a little help sometime. No one stands alone. Makes no difference if you're just a child like me, or a king upon a throne. For
darkest night
forever friend.
So the other song that Charlie is well known for is What Colour Is the Wind, which is also a beautiful song. I'm not sure if we have it in the book or not.
But well, it may be in the third book. As I was saying,
various people think that Charlie is Irish, but in fact his wife is Irish. She comes from Rooski in County Roscommon, I think it is. Charlie was one of 11 children. It's some little thing I read about him today. And he was born in 1941.
And he still loads a long hair.
And he's a beautiful voice still. Nancy, hello, Nancy from Nashville on your work and various others.
Hi, Paul Flaherty. It seems to be nice all over the country there today then. So that's we're only a small country when you think of all, you know, we don't need an awful lot of the sky to make ourselves, to give us a blue sky, if only the clouds would avoid us a bit more, you know.
Peggy, so here
when it does,
Pittsburgh.
It's nice.
Okay, Peggy's here from Pittsburgh.
How are you, Peggy?
So, I may lose you. I'm heading to the farm to work.
All right, so again, it's midday probably in the States.
It's about 1 or 2, it's about 2 o'clock, I'd say there. Yeah.
Probably that, yeah. So, look at it again. So, it's, as I say, it's, and Natalie, hi again. You're that bit further on, later on us. I think you're about 2 hours ahead of us, Natalie. So the next song we're going to sing, and again, hopefully people will enjoy singing the songs. That's really what it's about. A bit of practice, etc. We're going to sing Spancil Hill now. Mm. So it's Spancil Hill. I might just have to shoot through my books here. Spancil Hill. That's it.
It's a dream, this song, and it was written as a poem by a guy called Michael Considine, who during the famine he emigrated. He initially went to Boston and he spent a few years there. He was 20 years old when he went, and then he went out to California to follow the gold. He became ill, he knew he didn't have long to live, and he was writing about his love that he left at home. And the intention was that she would join him in America. But that never happened because he realized he didn't have long to live. And this is a poem he wrote, which was subsequently turned into a song. So various people who sings the song, the Dubliners and Jim McCann, I think, and various others.
And Christy Moore sings the song too. Sometimes you'll notice with the songs, if you're singing this song, you might think, oh, I know different words to that song. So, again, just to say, when we were compiling all these songs, we took on board the fact that there were many different renditions of the songs or variations of words. And in some way, we had to make some sort of a mishmash or executive decision on what versions we'd use. But I know when Christy Moore sings a song, there are some variations in the song, but these are equally pleasant as well.
So I don't know if you know where Spancil Hill is, but it's between Ennis and Tulla in County Clare. And Spancil Hill was a very well-known fair, horse fair, that took place there every year. And I don't know if any of you know what spanciling is, but that's what they did with the horses. They tied his left fore leg, if you want to call it that, to his right back leg. They do that to donkeys as well and various other animals. I don't think they do that anymore. It's probably illegal to do that right now. Anyway.
So again, before we came on here, I was just listening to a live stream by Nuala Kennedy from Ennis, beautiful singer and flute player from Dundalk, and it was very pleasant to hear Nuala's dulcet tones again. One of the songs we have, the Night Visiting Song, she has done a beautiful rendition on that as well. So we're going to play it open. Last night as I lay dreaming of pleasant days gone by, my mind went bent on rambling to Ireland I did fly, when stepped on board Charlie came to end. sleeping on the 23rd of June, the day before the fair. When the harlot sons and daughters and crowd assemble there, the young, the old, the brave and the bold, their duty to fulfill. There were jovial conversations at the fair of Spancil Hill. I went to see my neighbour to hear what they might say. The old ones were all dead and gone, the young ones turning grey. We met with the tailor quickly, he's as bowed as ever still. Sure he used to make my bridges when I lived in Spancil Hill. I paid a flying visit to my first and only love. She's white as any lily and gentle as a dove. She threw her arms around me saying, Johnny, I love you still. Oh, she'd met the farmer's daughter and the flower. I dreamed I sailed and kissed her as in the days of yore. Said, Johnny, you're only joking like many the time before. The cock, he crew in the morning, he crew both loud and shrill. And I awoke in California, many miles from Spancil.
So he never saw his love, whose name was Mary McNamara. He never saw her again.
Oh dear. Spancilin. So that's what spancilin mean. Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. That's what spancilin mean.
I can imagine poor Diego here if he had spancilin and I'm trying to get around the sand, digging holes in the sand with his back leg toward, his back right leg tied to his front right left paw. And his tail shaking in between them, you know.
And he swam quite a bit today, actually. Tell about how he swam.
He swims until his legs run out of ground and he doesn't like swimming anymore. Anyway.
Sunny and warm in Pittsburgh, rain tomorrow.
And so in London.
So it's back to work, going in your eyes, pants. I really love this song. Liked Christy Moore version, liked you singing it too, Liam and Mary. So there we are.
Well, I hope we would like you singing, which is important because at some point we're going to have an exam.
Yeah. Oh, and you're going to be first.
Just because they're cancelling.
We're going to test
just because they're spancilling the Leaving Cert at the moment in Ireland, the Leaving Certificate being the end of second level education. I think we'll have to introduce an exam for everybody who's turning up here. We'll get our statistics from the NSA.
We're going to get you all
chipped
first.
We're going to
get you all chipped.
We'll have geolocations and we'll call you on stage sometime to sing your song. So you want to be practicing there. And we're going to do the Irish Rover now, right? Again, delight anybody who's come in and who's maybe not familiar with the routine. It's a sing song and it's an online sing. So it's not about us singing a Jew. It's about us singing in communion with you guys out there, we hope. And we're singing out of a set of songbooks that we have, which are available if you just click on the Meitheal Ceol up at the top and then view the group and join it, apply to join there. And in there you get the, download the books for use and for distributing to friends or whatever. I mean, it's a wonderful tool to have these songs at your disposal. You know, you can pick up the songbook at any time, just kick in and have fun with a bit of songs, a few songs. Oh, that's lovely.
John Fitzgerald, before we move on to the next song, he said, Spancil Hill is one of my favourites.
Lovely. So, you know the great thing about these songs? They're all in, I don't think over all the generation. I know at my age, I suppose, you probably think this is all people have ever heard, but my sense, no matter where you go, they're lovely songs and they just last from generation to generation. And you've got bits of them in your head, but you may not have all the words. And that's why the effort of Mary and I put into to put this book together. The original book was, the first book was 365 songs, your one a day, the idea of it being like your vitamins A, B, C, D, E or whatever.
Anya O'Rourke is looking for a song called Oh Jesus.
Oh Jesus, in C. I now, see.
Tell us more about that song, Anya.
So we're going to play this one up in the Irish Rover in three. So again, we're encouraging you to, so the capo's in position three, whether you have a ukulele or a mandolin or whatever. So sometimes if you don't, if you play by ear, like I would play in the mandolin or whatever, you'll probably be able to pick out the tune anyway. But if you have a ukulele, and I think it's a great thing to have a capo because we can adjust it for the pitch that suits our voice at any one time. And so let's, I hope this works out for us all right. On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet of a Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall of New York. Was a wonderful crowd. Called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags. We had 2 million barrels of stone. We had 3 million sides of old blind horses' hides. We had 4 million barrels of bones. We had 5 million hogs. We had 6 million dogs and 7 million barrels of porter. We had 3 million bales of old Nanny Goat's tails in the hold of the Irish Rover. There was old Mickey Coote, who played flard on his flute when the ladies lined up for a set. He was tooting with skill with his sparkling quadrille, though the dancers were fluttered in bed. With his smart witty talk, he was cock of the walk, and he rolled the dames under and over. Though he had a glance when he took up his stance, that he sailed on the Irish Rover. Banks of the Lee, there was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of war, and a man from his meat called Malone. There was some girl too, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover, and your man Mick McCann. The banks of the band was the skipper of the Irish Rover. For a sailor, it's always a bother in life. It's so lonesome by night and by day that he longs for the shore and a charming young whore who will melt all his troubles away. The noise and the rouse will input Jean and Stout for him soon to torment is over. Of the love of a maid he is never afraid, an old salt from the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 seas when the measles broke out and our ship lost its way in the fog. Was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck the rock, oh Lord, what a shock. The bulkhead was turned right over, turned 9 times around. pour out, I was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rover.
Sweet cove, sweet cove.
Yeah, so again, just to say, for anybody who's wondered.
So, Anya, that was like Tourette's, I think. She said that that was when Lee mentioned an exam.
All right. Well, it's no harm to put a bit of the fear of God into you, as the fella says, you know.
Sean Lawless, good evening from Dundore, an extremely sunny Dundore.
Excellent, Sean.
Please excuse the language, she says.
I suppose you were out cutting the grass today, Sean, when you were walking around there. Anyway, the thing about the songs is that I've noticed that I used to know all these songs, or many of them off by heart, and since we put them into the book with the chords in them, I suppose the effort that we'd put into pulling all this stuff together, rather than trying to remember any of these, I'm just playing them off the book, etc. But we have often talked about picking out 7 or 8 songs that we like and that we get away with doing, or we enjoy doing them well, and actually trying to learn them so that we could pick up the instruments and play them together. I think that would be a bit of fun, which is what the whole exercise of, we're just coming up to 7:30, the next session we're going into, is that we're going to do 3 songs, which the 3 songs we're going to do, this is our 3rd night of doing them, Nancy Spain's Song for Ireland and The Town I Love So Well. So we're going to do a set of songs every number of days and try and say to ourselves, look, we got those songs under the belt and we can do those. And my suggestion to everybody, can't cut you off, by the way, or punish you in any way if you don't do your homework. But I think it would be, it's good to have a bit of an objective when we're doing this, to learn a couple of songs. So again, if you think, I recommend, download the books, have a look through them. If you think there's songs there we could all learn to sing together, or that you'd like to learn to practice, give yourself a bit of motivation.
On New York says, I did sing along with that song. Nestle says, love the song. Paul Flaherty says, what is it? Sweet Cove. So maybe one of these nights we might be able to do Cork.
I think Paul was talking about getting his guitar or getting a guitar. Mm. So again, we're going to be, we're going to be cocooned here until
we're not.
Until we turn into a little cocoon, into a butterfly or something. Mm. But it's not going to, it's going to take a while. So if you've got a chance to pick up an instrument somewhere, you know, you'll find after a couple of weeks that you get the hang of it. And most importantly, I think you can just take an instrument anywhere and play it for yourself and just enjoy it. And, you know, it's a great way of making conversation with other people as well. So we're going to go through our 3 songs now.
Nancy,
the first one is Nancy Spain.
Nancy for you, Nancy. And the other Nancy, if she's there.
Let's see, just pick it up here. Boom, 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 boom. So we hope you like the idea of doing these songs. They're all nice songs anyway. But if we sort of set ourselves, look, we will practice these and we will sort of make them part of our repertoire, let's say, and just set that as a task. Now, in this case, we're playing this one open, all right? So just play it as you see it, mm-hmm. All right? And again, I suppose, like many of the songs that I love about these, they're all visual songs, my sense, especially in this weather, some of the lovely way that the weather is coming good at the moment is really captured very much in this song. Of all the stars that ever shone, not one has twinkled like your pale light. Like golden corn at harvest time, your hair pulsating in my boat, the wind gently blows and fills my sail. Your sweet scented breath daylight peeping through the curtains of the past, and night time is your smile. The song in the sky is like your laugh. Come back to me, my Nancy, linger here for just a little while.
shores, I've known no eastern shore. No matter where I wander, I'm belonged by your name. The portrait of your beauty stays the same. Standing by the ocean, wondering where you've gone. On the day in spring, snow starts to melt and streams to flow. Oh, with the birds that sing the song, for in the wild I wander, down by bluebell grove where wildflowers grow. And I hope my lovely Nancy will return. No matter where I wander, I'm still haunted by your name. The portrait of your beauty stays the same. Standing by the ocean, wondering where you've gone, if you return again. Where is the ring I gave to Nancy Spain?
What are you going to give a try, Nigel O'Mahony?
Lovely.
Nigel O'Mahony says, thanks, Joe. I will give it a try.
Yeah, so again, you know, the important thing here is, as with all the nights when we sing with them, others, when we physically been singing with them, I think the important thing is that there's no such thing as bad singing in this. I mean, it's one of the saddest things I find in this country is that talking to a woman some time ago, a tall woman who's a teacher, so, you know, she was working in a career where she stands in front of people, so she's had to develop self-confidence. And she's got absolutely zero self-confidence in singing because all through her secondary school years, which happened to be with the nuns, but I don't think that's particular, has to do with the phase of education that was going on in Ireland at the time, and maybe still does. So she was tall and striking, so she was told to stand in the back row by the teacher and told to mouth all the words, but not to make a sound. You can't sing, you just sit and mouth the words. So it just seemed to me that at almost 60 years of age then, she was still really, you know, didn't feel good about herself in terms of saying, I can't sing, I can't sing. And when she sang, she was perfectly fine.
Nancy loved that, by the way.
So this is our second song that we're doing, a song for Ireland. Yeah, so we're playing this open, isn't that right?
I don't know, I can't just remember.
Mary remembers, she writes all the things.
I can't, no, you have a bit of paper there, you have things written on it, and I can't see it. Okay.
So we're going to play it open, guys. Walking all the day near tall towers where falcons will their nests. Silver wing they fly. Sky with twisted rocks that run down to the sea. Living on your western shore, saw summer sunsets as for more. I stood by your Atlantic sea and sang a song for us. Talking all the day with true friends who try to make you stay. Telling jokes and news, singing songs that pass the night away. Watch the Galway salmon run like silver dance. Living on your western shore, saw
hot summer sunsets ask for more. I stood by your Atlantic sea and sang a song for Ireland, drinking all the day. Someone touched the bow, he played a reel which seemed so grand and gay. Stood on Dingle Beach and cast in wild foam, we found Atlantic bass. Living on your western shore, saw summer sunsets as from home. I stood by your Atlantic sea and sang a song for Ireland, dreaming in the night. I saw falcons fly, and it twists and turns all in your every sky. Living on your western shore, saw summer sunset as for more. I stood by your Atlantic sea, sang a song for
So again,
Anderson,
I hope that I hope you liked that song, both of those songs, and we're going to go and do the last one, The Town I Love So Well. But I'm a bit surprised really that this particular exercise of the song a day and what we're doing here is it's radically different on everything else. I mean, we watched the One World concert, bits of it last night, because some of it on the news. There was a clip of the Rolling Stones singing "You Can't Always Get What You Want," and it showed the four of them in four quartiles, all apparently singing together. And that's not real. It's not what's happening at all. These are pre-produced. I see Paddy Beefy Barton was doing. He's still at the multiple representation of himself. He was orthogonally discharged, doing a couple of songs, playing on multiple instruments, but again, and playing with the a cappella, I presume a cappella app that he's working on. But the bottom line, it's a technical thing called latency. The difference when you start a clock and I say one, and whenever you hear it, it'll be a number of seconds later, no matter what happens. In fact, when I was listening to Nuala Kennedy's live stream earlier, I was listening to two different devices and they were coming through at different delays. So all you know is that we know that when you hear in the room you're in, you're hearing it as we're singing it. We will appear to be singing to you in real time. But obviously we can't all sing over and back to each other. But the other thing is, everything else is going on is people singing at you. And this is not our either intention. In fact, if we're singing at you, we want to charge you. So please tell us there, and we start running the clock. It'll be 10 cents a minute, like Sylvia's mother says, you know, the operator said 20 cents more. So this is really about you guys singing. This is ultimately what it's about. Singing, enjoying the songs, thinking about the words. Like, that's the beauty of having the words up in front of you, that you get a chance to, as someone said to me before, you know, I often heard these songs, but I never got the chance to read the lyrics and look at them. And of course, that's the lyrics are, some of them are absolutely beautiful. So the third one in our list of sort of reusable learning objects is The Town I Love So Well. And just to say to the other thing, you can always, I keep repeating this, and I really don't know as an educator or in the land of education where people really understand this concept of reusable learning objects, that you go back and you play this again and again and again, or anything that you want to learn. I mean, that's the beauty in education. You usually go to class, and if you miss out on something, the teacher says, "That's it, you lost it. You're lost," and it might affect your whole learning from then on. But in this case, you can go back at any time. That's the town I love so well.
Onion, New York said it was a lovely song. Mm. Louis Brown from Suffolk said a gorgeous song. Very nicely sung.
Mm. Okay,
and
again,
he likes the bits about the falcons and the birds and stuff like
that. Yeah, that's great. No, sorry, again, that we're doing this song. Where is this? The town? Yeah, so we're doing this in a different key just to suit our voices here at the moment. Again, it's in the book in a particular key. And using your capo and your little transformer, the transformation table at the front page, we'd recommend that you find a key that works with you. Is it two or three, Mary, do you know?
Yeah,
Will it be in the book?
Yeah, but we have to go find where it is in the book now, you know.
So it's in page 402 and one in the first book. That's the second book.
I know that.
So we're just trying to find out. We had a note written down on what capo position this is in 402.
Mm-hmm. Near enough. Nothing.
Okay, so we haven't recorded this. Maybe you'll record it this time then.
Yes, we will. We will.
I think it might be in two. I'm not sure.
Try two anyway.
The lowest element. Okay, so we're trying in capo position two, using the chords that you see in front of you. So again, you know the history of this song. We've talked about it before, but the beauty of the song is just the story of a town going through, as it went through the whole troubles, and still the sense of survival in the song.
Natalie remembers. She says, "I believe it was capo two." And
excellent.
Kathy Anderson and Teresa Laverty are there from Bally Buffet. So this song is for you, girls, Teresa and Kathy, okay?
Capo position two. In my memory, I will always see the town.
There are I spent my youth, and to tell you the truth, I was sad to leave it all behind me, where I learned about life, and I found my way in the town I love so well.
But when I returned, oh, my eyes, how they burned to see how the town
be brought to its knees. And the armored cars and the bomb-out bars and the gas that tanks on to the breeze. Now the army's installed by the tall gas yard wall, and the damned barbed wire gets higher and higher with their tanks and their guns. Oh my God, what have they done to the town I love so well?
Now the music's gone, but they carry on, for the spirit's been
tomorrow and peace once again.
Now what's done is done, and what's won is won, and what's lost is lost and gone forever. I can only pray for a bright brand new day for the time.
Song, one of my favorite songs.
So again, how easy it is just to go through a couple of songs. I hope that, as I said, we're probably halfway through, at least we've done that three nights in a row now, just to be interesting whether anybody out there feels that they're getting more familiar with the songs. Or Ray Bourne, there you've talked about you wanting to, you know, as a learner, what that experience is like for you, Ray, in terms of, are you getting more comfortable with the chord change, etc. And again, Mary pointed out last night, if you miss a chord in the sequence, don't worry, once you read ahead you can see where to
just pick it up wherever you
hook
can
up again. And in time, as you so the song cycles, it's good. And look at I wouldn't want to be preaching to you, but all the time you have to practice at the moment, because I'm still practicing the idea of going out to cut the grass. I went a wee bit further today. I did act one scene when I opened the garage door and then satisfied myself that the battery was run down and the ride on more. So I've done a lot of work today. I put it on the charger.
And I'm going to be strimming tomorrow, I think.
So, but we also made another piece of work. We couldn't find the strimmer. So there are actions. But, you know, nonetheless, if you've really run out of everything else to be bored about, and then there's housework and all this. But if you leave those things aside, you can always just say, save the video, play it back during the day and pick one of those songs you like and say, just practice it yourself.
I want to tell you about the strimmer. It's Workforce, isn't it?
It's Workhorse.
Workforce. Is that the name of the strimmer? It's light anyway, and I can use it. And it has little small batteries, and we have numbers of them. So the battery lasts about 20 minutes, but I'm able to handle it. Is it workforce?
Debenhams is closed, so women's fashion is gone. This is what's happened, women out there.
No longer talk about hair
and clothes. And look at my t-shirt and all this. And we're now talking to
denied.
Women.
They're denying.
Women are talking about strimmers.
No this human particular rights strimmer. For women.
We could run one of those, what do you call them? TV programs where you sell things, you know, Mary could tell you. But yes, when my strimmer lasted 23 minutes with the battery on full power. But look at, I suppose I love motors. I just love electric motors, and the days of rechargeable batteries and motors. And you know, the one thing I never ever could ever accept in a world of supposed sustainability, why we can't just make a standard battery like the AA and the AAA batteries to fit every type of device in the universe, you know, instead of every clown making, you know, how many electric drills have guys got back in their sheds with batteries that are wasted they can never get replacements for? Built-in obsolescence, chindongos of all time.
Ray Burns.
Don't get me started.
Ray Burns says, song for Ireland, a challenge, but getting there. Nigel O'Mahony says, work often extends to the time available to do it. So, look, we spend 3 hours.
And we run out of time. We had flasks
and beautiful sandwiches and everything.
Now to teach the dog, don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. We're trying to teach the dog that song.
Nigel,
he really doesn't like swallowing seawater.
Nigel, you said this twice. That is obviously an important message. That work often extends the time available to do it. Okay, what are we doing next?
So we're going to try a lovely song now, The Massacre of Glencoe. And it was Brian Laverty who taught us this song when we used to go into Letterkenny to the... We were part of a guitar sing-song on a Tuesday and then a Thursday night in Tiernanog. So Tiernanog would be like Never Never Land in Disney town.
Forever Young.
But the Irish Celtic mythology about the land that never ate, where you never age. So there's an Irish poem called Tá Tiernanog ar Cúlann Tí Tír Óling Trí Dé Céile. So that's like that, the magic Never Never Land's at the back of your house. And some days, our back of our house is facing directly west, and if, like this evening, there isn't a breeze, that's exactly what it is. So The Massacre of Glencoe, we think, Brian would tell us that the Currys did this, I think.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if Brian is there tonight or not.
The Massacre of Glencoe.
Yeah.
I think it's D1, so we're in, I think
we're
doing
it. Pages have now
written it. Hold on, I just want to see if I can get it. Yeah, so it's in page 380. I've put them in.
Okay.
So I think we're putting this in capo position one. I think it was the Currys that did this. So it's a Scottish song about massacre between Scottish clans or something.
So Teresa Laverty is
Brian's sister-in-law.
This
is why we didn't say anything bad about
it. I think Brian's sister-in-law. And what Teresa is saying, Kathy, that would have been Karen's dad. So obviously Brian has a daughter called Karen. So hello, Karen, Brian. One, is it?
So the capo's in position one. Again, if you haven't this song, I think you'll like it. Again, the chorus, we sing between the verse. Lovely, lovely, lovely chorus. But, you know, again, more of these butchering Celts. They really hit the slaughtering and butchering and sticking daggers into each other, etc.
Was it the O'Donnells and the McDonald's or something, was it?
It's like before McDonald's closed down for the COVID.
All cruel is the snow that sweeps Glencoe and covers the grave of Donald. And cruel was the foe that raided Glencoe and murdered the house of MacDonald. They came through the blizzard, he offered them heat, a roof for their heads, dry shoes for their feet. Covers the grave of Donald, and cruel was the foe that raped and foe, murdered the house of MacDonald. He came from Fort William with murder in mind, the Campbell's had orders, King William had signed, put all to the sword, these were lying. All cruel is the snow that sweeps Glencoe and covers the grave O'Donnell, and cruel was the foe that raided Glencoe and murdered the house of MacDonald. They came in the night when the men were asleep, that band of horses among helpless sheep. They slaughter the house of MacDonald. How cruel is the snow that we plant low, covered with the grave of Donald. And cruel was the foe that raped Glencoe and murdered the house of MacDonald. Some died in their beds at the hands of their foe. Some fled in the night, were lost in the snow. Some lived to accuse him that struck the first blow.
So the Corries, I wouldn't have ever really heard of the Corries, though I since then I probably looked at a number of their songs. They're a lovely, lovely group. And it's amazing. Well, you know, even if you take the 500 songs that we put into this book, and now the first book was 365 songs.
Oh.
And initially we were trying to work out songs to put in, and then we sat down, we racked our brains and looked up, and then suddenly we had a massive list, so we had to leave songs out. And that's where the second book here came from. Where's our little book here? Where's our book there?
So many pictures.
Sorry, that's the two books there. But the second book, the ones that got away, there was about 130 songs or more in that. But these were ones that didn't fit into the first book that we just picked up. And since then, you know, with all the time in the world, we still haven't made any progress in the last few weeks. But we have a skeleton of a third book called The Ones That Came Under the that Went Under the Radar. And as we look around, there are so many, and there's just so many beautiful songs. And probably I wouldn't be listening to an awful lot of, I don't know what pop music is or modern or whatever. A lot of songs I don't hear that are probably very nice songs as well. I'm saying I'm doing well if I can learn a couple of songs. But isn't it lovely that you never run out of nice songs to distract you, to associate different things with, etc. So Mary likes the next song.
Well, before we go on, Maureen Duver. Hello, Maureen. How are you?
And you're
very
Maureen?
Welcome. Kathy Anderson said, I was digging flower beds today and got some flowers planted, and Peter was mowing the lawn.
Oh,
so that was a lovely day for that, Kathy and Peter.
Yeah, and I suppose, you know, while we're thinking about the idea of actually going out to cut the grass, you see, the good thing is the weather was a bit colder earlier on, there was very little growth. Now it's beginning to take off. But I suppose if you can get on top of it, and if we have to be at home for a length of time, maybe doing a bit every day would become a bit of a joy rather than a chore, which would be a nice change for me.
I suppose one doesn't have to do it all at once either, you know.
Well, you wouldn't want to do it all at once, then you'd have nothing to do except sing songs. So the next one, Mary picked this one, was Two Sisters.
I love this.
She thinks we sing this well. So
Mary, O'Gogan, this is for you down there in Newbridge. You have a lot of sisters, or you have a number of sisters, as do I. On Your Earth says, I remember that poem, Tiernan Og. Where is she gone? I remember that poem, Tiernan Og, Shangri-La.
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 You know, it would be nice if somebody's out there and you obviously can't be playing and running the screens and all the rest at the same time. But again, maybe somebody might pick up the words of that thing and dump them into the, put them into the comment list there. Again, look at the wonderful opportunity. We can't all be in the same room chatting and shaking hands and all that sort of stuff. But what we can do is, you know, be creative about how we use the interactions. And, you know, Mary spends a lot of time going through the comments and reacting to them, etc. So it would be, please do keep sending the comments and comment to each other and make suggestions. Again, hiya Fergus too. So again, but I think that Ceol page, click on the post, write something which allows you to add a photo. Oh yeah, that's it. Yeah, Joe, I mean, so I think you can add in photos in there into what we're doing. I think you should be able to add in a photo into the comment stream. So anyway, look, we're playing Two Sisters on position three, capo position
three. Before that, Paul Flaherty is with us from Covan. We're going to sing a Cork song one of the nights, aren't we? Something about Cork.
Are we?
Oh, well, I think we are, yeah. So, Mary O'Gogan says, thanks.
Mary wants to sing the My Only Lovely Lee because we haven't found a pitch to sing at it. But Mary wants
sang it down at Loch. What was it? Tell Paul where we were.
We tried to sing it earlier today. That was My Own Lovely we were trying to sing.
The one we sang down in Cork.
No, the one that we were too high and too low. We get it right yet. Don't worry, Paul.
When we're ready, I said one of these days.
Okay. We won't go to the other capital, the alternative capital of Ireland, without knowing how to sing that song. But the one I will sing for you soon is the Johnny Jump Up.
So have any
never again. If I live to be 110. For I fell to the ground and I couldn't get up after drinking a quart of the
Johnny jumped up.
Well, capo position three.
Mary Wogan.
Two sisters side by side. Sing I don't, sing I may. There were two sisters side by side. The boys are born for me. There were two sisters side by side. The eldest, your young Johnny, cried. I'll be true unto my love if he'd be true to me. Johnny, but the youngest, the gay gone ring. Sing I don't. Johnny, but the youngest, the gay gone ring, the boys are born for me. Johnny brought the youngest, the gay gold ring, he never brought the eldest a single thing. I'll be true unto my love if he'll be true to me. Johnny brought the youngest, the beaver hat, sing I don't, sing I day. But the youngest, the beaver had, the boys are born for me. Johnny brought the youngest, the beaver had, the eldest didn't think much of that. I am true unto my love, if he'll be true to me. As they were a-walking by the foamy brim, sing I dumb, sing I day. Walking by the foamy brim, the boys are bound for me. As they were a walking by the foamy brim, the eldest pushed the youngest in. True unto my love, if he'll be true to me. Oh sister, give me thy hand. Sing I dumb, sing I day. Sister, oh sister, give me thy hand, the boys are born for me. Sister, oh sister, give me thy hand, and you can give Johnny all his land. I'll be true unto my love, if he'll be true to me. Oh sister, I'll not give you my hand, sing I don't, sing I may. Sister, I'll not give you my hand, the boys are born for me. Sister, I'll not give you my hand, and I'll have Johnny and all his land. I'll be true unto my love, if he'll be true to me. So away she sang, and away she smiled, sing I don't, sing I may. She sank and away she swam, the boys are born for me. Away she sank and away she swam, until she came to the pillars down. Unto my love, he'll be true to me. The miller, he took her gay gold ring, sing I don't, sing I day. The miller, he took his gay gold ring, the boys are born for me. The miller, he took her gay gold ring, then he pushed her in again. True unto my love, if he'll be true to me. The miller, he was
that lovely? I don't think any of us have a sister like that, have we? Girls.
Anyway, the beautiful thing about those type of songs that they're all stories. You know, I like them. I like the fact that they're really about telling a story. So what have we got now?
Well, Ray Byrne is saying the Brennans were originally based in Omeath on the Cooley Peninsula.
All right, so that's, I presume you're talking about, I think that might be, I'm not sure if that's a Clannad song, it might be.
I think it is, actually.
I always wonder, was there a woman called Maria O'Donnell up here who used to sing that song, but I think possibly is it. So if it is the Clannad, that's interesting that you say that. The Clannad are from Leo O'Brien's children, from Leo's pub up here, not far from where we are, but it may well be. And if they were from Omeath, it might have been from the Gaeltacht, that would be the last sort of Gaeltacht on that part of the East Coast, probably back in the 30s, in the 1930s. But so they may be from there, that'd be interesting.
Terry Griffin. Hello, Terry. How are you? Terry? Paul Flaherty said, you would be very welcome in the real capital.
Oh, yeah. What's the...
The real capital.
Come
Paul
on,
Flaherty. Do you know what it is? Paul Flaherty's looking for the contender.
Well, we'll sing that afterwards, Paul. It's in the book somewhere. We'll certainly have a go.
Here we are. Tom Waits does a version of The Two Sisters.
Tom Waits does, all right.
Or is it... Are you talking about The Two Sisters
of
the
contender? Oh, might well be, yeah. Could... No. We'll do the contender in a while, but
we're
Travelling People, that's the one we're going to have a look at now. So again, I can't impress upon you enough the importance of seeing whatever we're doing here as different on all the other YouTube stuff that's out there. Insofar as, I would love to think that we could join and see other YouTube things, we could sing along like this here. It's a great way of getting introduced to songs. And the fact is, you know, endlessly, you can just use YouTube, any of these videos, to wind them back and have a listen to them again. And if you just want to learn one particular song, well, then you can just practice at that. So Travelling People is one we're playing. It's played in open campo. Yeah.
So Louis Brown in Suffolk, this is for you and your grandmother. I'm sure she's not alive anymore. She's passed on. So you like this song.
So, lovely song. And I suppose the sentiments or the concept, I suppose, as motorhomers, and Keith Paddy Beefy Burton and Valerie, his wife, they're motorhomers as well. And we know that some motorhomers listen in and join in. And this, the reason probably like the when you're in a motorhome, it's a bit like going camping when you're a younger person. Yeah, it's just that sense of freedom. They call it the idea of wild camping is when you stay outside, you don't stay in campsites, etc. And it's not because you're stingy. Being stingy is a sort of separate issue altogether. But it's the idea of you just pulling up somewhere. You see that third verse there? Was open ground where a man could linger for a week or two, for time was not our master. Imagine the idea of time not being your master. Because in a way, time is our master now. I mean, just the other side, this is not like Travelling People. We're non-travelling people.
We're very busy, but
all of us, we're not allowed to travel. So this is not the idea of that. But imagine the world where you could come and go as you please. And, you know, we're only a short time on the planet anyway, and wouldn't it be nice to have a look around when we're at it? Anyway, enough of that.
So Cathy Anderson says, I think the Corrs are from County Louth. They are from County Louth, yeah.
It's not the Corrs.
It's not the Corrs, no.
The people I was thinking who did Glencoe are the Corries.
Yeah,
C-O-R-I-E-S. They're a Scottish group.
That's right.
Lovely group. Again, I wouldn't have known them had it not been for Carl McGlynn and Paula Wallace and Brian Laverty introducing us to them. Lovely group. So let's go with this. Open. I think the Johnsons might have used to sing this song,
but
I
love it again. That's right.
I'm a freeborn man of the Travelling People. Got no fixed abode, but nomads I ever wander. Country lanes and byways were always my way. I never fancied being lumber. Oh, we knew the woods and the resting places. Oh.
time was not our master. Then away you jog with your horse and dog. They said, Daisy, know me to go faster. And sometimes you'd meet up with other travelers. Hear the news or else what family information. At the country fairs we'd be meeting there. All the people love the traveling nation. I met Willow Perils and the Heather Beasons. And I've even done some betting and some hawking. And I've laid their spend wrapped up in my tent. And I've listened to the old folks talking. Now I've known life hard and I've known life easy. And I've cursed the life when the days were dawning. But I've laughed and sung through the whole night long. Seen summer sunrise in the morning. All you freeborn men of the traveling people. Every tinker, rolling stone, gypsy rover. Winds of change are blowing. Always are going. Your traveling day will soon be over.
Lovely, lovely, lovely.
It's lovely looking out the window on an early. I suppose it's still spring, is it? Spring.
Spring.
Still spring
for another week or so.
But and looking forward to the summer and that sense of that song and what it brings. But. So maybe in this all of this time of incarceration, and there's opportunities for reflection, and you know, I think whatever else happens about what happens on the other side, whichever side we come out on, it would be nice, I think, for everybody not to just become preoccupied and over busy again. And we're not busy.
We're very busy.
We're not busy.
We are. We're out walking.
But we haven't time to do anything.
Yeah. What did Nigel say? I'm always on time, even if I'm late. Bruce McLaughlin is watching from Cleggan in County Galway. She's my sister.
You missed her singing about the second sister there, Bridge.
The two sisters. Did you hear the two sisters, Bridge? And Bridge, is there a song you would like us to play for you? And Mary O'Gogan, would you please tell us if there's a song you'd like us to sing?
Somebody did ask us, so don't know if we get
the contender. Yeah.
Well, before we forget it, we look for that contender song now. It's in the, I don't know if it's under C. No, it's probably the contender. So let me see, under the. The.
So Joe Kane says another lovely song by Ewan McCall.
Yeah, it's a. I haven't sung this in a good while, and it'll be interesting to. I don't know who sings this song.
Well, he says it's Ewan McCall.
No, Ewan McCall is Travelling People.
Oh, that was a Travelling People, yeah. Ewan McCall.
But the contender, I'm not sure. I have heard Christy Moore sing it.
Somebody tell us.
I think someone else I've heard sing it as well, but who I really was very, very taken with singing it was Paul McGrath. Paul McGrath, the magic.
That was lovely, yeah.
The Black Pearl, the most magnificent, magical, loving, lovable footballer with all his foibles, etc., has sung this song. I saw him somewhere and he had sung it, and I just thought, well, everything about it, the song was magically authentic, you know. So I don't know where this pitch is around, but look, we'll try it, because even if we don't get it right today, we should learn that one. I think it's well worth it.
Oh, so we have another one here. Bridget McLaughlin says, yes, I love the contender. And Anne Simmons says she would like a Donegal song.
We'll play it open.
I was young and I was in my day. I could stall what woman's heart there was away, sing and dance into the morning, blaze away until the dawning, long before I was the man you see today. I was born beneath the star that promised all. I could have lived my life twixt Cork and Coventry, but the wheel of fortune took me from the highest point she shook me. By the bottle I should fall. There in the mirror on the wall, I see the dream is fading from the contender to the pro.
That's wrong.
That's not right.
There in the mirror on the wall, I see the dream is fading from the contender to the pro. The ring, the rose, the matador is red. Say we haven't done this.
No.
When I die, I'll die a drunk down on the street. You can count me out to then and clearly feed. Wrap the starry flower around me. Let the piper's air resound me. There I'll rest until the Lord of love I meet. There in the mirror on the wall, I see the dream is fading from the contender to the pro. The ring, the road, the matador is raving.
We need to do better. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, God, that's we it. Have to anyway.
We have to do that. We have to do that.
Just again, you know the thing about when there's so many songs here. Again, just to remind you. So how do we get that song? So we just, if on each page of the PDF, if you press the little link there to YouTube video, there you are. There's the man himself, Paul McGrath, singing that song. Now,
highest point she shook me, by the bottle live and by the bottle I shall fall. But there in the mirror on the wall, I see the dream is fading from the contender to the brawl. The ring, the rose, the matador is raving.
So
we'll have to learn that.
And when I die,
look, what's important, guys, this is the magic of this book. I don't care. I look at this and I said, what a, you know, I've lived a life as an engineer, a professional engineer, as a college lecturer and all the rest, and this is the only useful thing I ever did in my life.
So here we are.
Let's put this book together. It's absolutely magic, even if I say it myself.
Well, this is interesting. Paul Flaherty says, thanks. My late dad went to school with Jack.
Oh, the boxer, isn't he?
Yeah,
the boxer,
yeah. Jack Dempsey, was it?
Oh, right. I don't know who was on. It wasn't Jack Dempsey.
Well, Jack. Tell us who it was. Jack what? Ruth Cleary is just here. You missed your song, Ruth. And Mary Gogan. Book 2, Killing Me Softly. Killing Me Softly was your song.
Okay, we'll try that. We got to do Love's Been Good to Me. Book. Love's Been Good to Me. We're going to go on to Book 2 now, so we'll find that in Book 2.
Mm-hmm.
Love's Been Good to Me. So
we'll
see.
Would you Love Been Good to Me first, Mary? And then we'll try
Love's Been Good to Me.
So yes, of course.
As you can see, when we take a song we haven't done for a long time, sometimes we make a mess with it over. But the whole thing about singing in a sing song like that is that, and when we sing in a group, typically, everybody, what the way it operates is you simply go around the circle and everybody who's there, no matter a visitor, player, accompanist or whatever, everybody has to pick a song and we all sing it. So it actually gets us through the songs. Again, John Coyle, you were there earlier tonight. How are you doing, John? Because this reminds us of, you know, the fun we had together singing and the focus it gives you and a bit of motivation to keep playing. That's what's really nice.
So the thing about it is, Paul Doyle says that that was Jack Doyle.
Jack Doyle, Paul Griffin.
Paul Flaherty.
Jack Doyle, that's what the guy's name is. Yeah. So we're going to play this in position two. Don't know who sang this either.
Yeah, we do Frank Sinatra.
Oh, was it old Frank Sinatra, was it? Perry Como probably did it as well.
1969 album, A Man Alone. Okay.
Oh, all right. Capo position two.
Two. Hang on.
Okay. I've been a rover. I have walked alone. I've a 100 highways. Never found a home. Still and all I'm happy. The reason is you see. Once in a while along the way, love's been good to me. There was a girl in Denver before the summer storm. Oh, her eyes were tender, oh, her arms were warm. And she could smile away the thunder, kiss away the rain. Even though she's gone away, you won't hear me complain. I have been a rover, I have walked alone. I've a 100 highways, never found a home. Still in all I'm happy, the reason is once in a while along the way, love's been good to me. There was a girl in Portland before the winter chill. We used to go a-courting along October Hill. She could laugh away the dark clouds, cry away the snow. Even seems like only yesterday, as down the road I go. I have been a rover, I have walked alone. I've a 100 highways, never found a home. Still and all I'm happy, the reason is you see. Once in a while along the way, love's been good to me. There was a girl in Houston out where the hard winds blow. I had to leave her, God Almighty knows. She could take the long hot summer,
sing that years ago. Maybe, you know, when you just get a telly, we probably got a telly back, black and white television, 1973.
What was that song Mary asked for, sorry? What's this song?
Killing Me Softly.
Killing Me Softly. Book two.
K-K-K-I-J-I-J. IJKKK.
19,000 steps today, folks. 19,000. What about that?
Strumming my pain. Okay, so we're going to play it open. You know, I always thought this song, you know, when I was doing a disco and I used to play different records, etc. You know, I wasn't necessarily ever focusing on playing the top 20, just like playing songs that were nice, either good dancing songs. I knew the bride when she used to rock and roll. At the hop, bop, bop, boop, bop, ba da ba. Rave on, rave up until. Anyway, but that. See, for the slow songs, but people often say to me, what's your favourite record? And this always seemed to come out of my mind. Killing Me Softly with his song by Roberta Flack always seemed to pop out of the top of my head. Now, I suppose there are many, many beautiful songs, but just the way she used to sing this is just absolutely gorgeous, you know.
Strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words. Killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life with his word, killing me softly with his song. I heard he sang a good song. And listen for a while, and there he was, this young boy, a stranger to my eyes, strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my
absolute gorgeous, gorgeous song. So Mary, I hope you're keeping well and singing through all of this.
Mary's a beautiful singer.
Not sure how your choir operates, and with all the choirs everywhere, hard to know how they can operate under these conditions. But
Mary's got a twin sister, Anne, and she's also a beautiful singer. Yeah.
My God, where was this? Patrick was a gentleman at three.
Patrick was a gentleman.
Let's see. Patrick was a gentleman again. Yeah, so last night we sang the Ballad of St. Patrick. Some people like to seem to enjoy it. And again, what I like about this, another beautiful song like that as well. But it's the, I just love the words in them. Look at the words here. Yeah, the toads went pop and the frogs went hop, slap, dash into the water. The snakes committed suicide to save themselves from slaughter. 100,000 reptiles blue he charmed with sweet discourses and dined at them in Killaloo and soup and other courses. How do you get it? How do you do this stuff? Just magic. So I'm not sure how I'm going to be able to move the words of this, because I had to, they were all trying to be pushed in to get them onto a page at the time. We're playing them in capo position 3. So again, if you haven't heard it before, I hope you'll enjoy it. Again, if you like these, we can go back and make these songs, the songs we can practice, etc. But what I think about these songs is really well worth reading the text carefully, so you can sort of see the words coming as they come along.
Patrick was a gentleman, he came from days of people, he built the church, Dublin town, and on it put a steeple. His father was a Gallagher, his uncle was a Grady, his aunt was an O'Shaughnessy, his mother was a Brady. The Wicklow hills are very high, and so's the hill of Hotser. There's a hill much higher still, much higher than the Hotser. Not the top of this high hill, St. Patrick preached the sermon. He drove the frogs into the bogs and banished all the vermin. Oh, there's not a mile in Erin's Isle where dirty vermin mustered, but there he put his deer for foot, murdered them in clusters. The toads went up and the frogs went up, slap dash into the water. Snakes committed suicide to save themselves from slaughter. 100,000 reptiles blue he charmed with sweet discourses. He dined with them in Killaloo at stoops and second courses, where blind worms crawling in the grass disgusted all the nation. Right down the holy spell, he changed their situation. Oh, it's no wonder that the same Irish boys should be so gay and frisky. Sure, St. Patty taught them that as well as making whiskey. No wonder that the saint himself should understand the still ill, for his mother kept a shebeen shop near the town of Enniskillen. Oh, was I but so fortunate as to be back in Ulster, I'd be bound that from the crown I never more would once stir. There's Patrick planted turf, campages and praties, pigs galore, and a grove of star, altar boys and ladies.
Wow, imagine. It
lovely,
ends,
lovely
it
song.
Ends very abruptly though, doesn't it?
Yeah. Now, what was I looking for? There was a song I was looking at earlier today. Can you look it up in the...
What is it?
It's on page... So what did I say it was?
I don't know.
Some of them were...
Oh, yeah. After the Deluge.
After the Deluge. After the Gold Rush. No, so it must be in the second book, sorry.
After
it's in the second book there. Just have a look at it where it's
after
pitched.
After the Deluge, okay.
After the Deluge. After the Deluge. It's not a fuck it, After the Deluge. Is it in book one, is it?
I don't
before,
know.
Sorry, it's before the Deluge.
Oh, before the Deluge.
We were going to sing after the Deluge, but we had to get to before the Deluge first. What is it?
Before.
No, but if what, you go onto the page, just tell me what track it's on. 26.
B-E. Before, page 26.
26,
yeah.
No, will you go into the, it's 26 and see where it's on. So I've been trying to write down somewhere where we'd put the capo in these things.
26.
This song is a song by, I think it's Jackson Brown.
It's on
capo position 2. It's a Jackson Brown song. again, I think Christy Moore might sing the song, but originally I would have heard Jack Sabrat say it. I loved it. Not sure where we can play it around, but I just, again, I hope you enjoy the words, the thoughts that are in these words, because they, in a lot of ways, they, to me, they epitomize what's going on here at this time. You know, we are, this tsunami or the deluge that's come over us really changed our whole lives. So it's position two.
Yeah.
Some of them were dreamers, and some of them were fools who were making plans and thinking of the future with the energy of the universe. They would gather in the tombs, they would need to make the journey back to nature. While the sand slipped through the opening and their hands reached through the golden ring, with their hearts they turned to each other's hearts for refuge. In the troubled year that came before the deluge, let the music keep your spirits high. Let the muted buildings keep our children dry. Let creation reveal its secrets by and by. By and by. When the light that's lost within us reaches the sky. Some of them you pleasure, some of them you pain. Some of them it was only the moment that mattered. And on that brave and crazy wing they went flying around in the rain. Their feathers once so fine grew torn and tattered. In the end they traded their tired wing for the resignation of living brew. In exchange, love's bright and fragile, over the mirror and the room. In the moment they were swept before the deluge, let the music keep our spirits high. Let the feelings keep our children dry. Let creation reveal secrets by and by. By and by. With the light that's lost within us reaches the sky. Oh, some of them were angry with the way the earth was abused by the men who learned how to forge. They struggled to protect her from them, only to be confused by the magnitude of her fury and the final hour. When the sand was gone and the time arrived, in the naked dawn only a few survived. In attempt to understand the things so simple and so huge, believe that they were meant to live after the death. Let the music keep your spirits high. Let the building keep our children high. Let creation reveal its secrets by and by. By and by. The light that's lost within us reaches the sky.
You know the other one that's lovely too, is you know the Christy Merle.
Some of them were angry at the way the air closed the view by the man. So So just put that up and change that to 3. Will
yeah,
you?
That's
I think
right.
That might have been nicer in 3.
It is, right.
And I hope you liked it. I don't know whether you know that song, but I think it's a gorgeous song by Jackson Browne. And from what I know I heard that song a long, long, long time ago. Like Jackson Browne, whenever, anytime I see him, he always looks the same as he did in 1977 when I saw him in Philadelphia, playing in Philadelphia. Never seemed to have changed an iota. But he wrote those songs very as a young man, a really insightful stuff as a young man to have written.
Fergus Toohey, Mary Fitzsimons.
What about this song, Beautiful Affair Mary?
Yeah, we will do that. But just to say, Paul Flaherty there says,
yeah.
Moving Hearts did a great version.
Oh, that's right, of Before the Deluge, yeah. And again, with their multiple ensemble.
Kevin Starrs. Hello, Kevin Starrs. Let's say hello, Kevin Starrs.
Hiya, Kevin. I was just wondering what we'll sing.
What did you say?
No, well, that would have been Billy
Beautiful
D.
Affair.
Billy D. So, anyway, I hope you're out cutting the grass there today, Kevin. I know we had good weather everywhere in Ireland today, I think. Thank God. Nice to have that for a... It's nice to be in the middle of this incarceration at this time when we're heading towards the bright evenings and all the rest. At least we'd say that in the good days. The great thing about Ireland, we'll always have to talk about the weather. Just change it before the deluge to 3, will you?
I did.
There it is there. Wrong song.
Oh, wrong song. That was a 2
then. Mary sent the wrong book.
Yeah.
Does it matter? No.
Yeah,
leave that.
That's
world.
Two. That's two.
Yeah, okay.
And then Before the Deluge,
yeah, okay.
Which one did we do? See, here's was
17 when he turned 21. So this song is a song by Chris Christopherson. I know there's a lot of Chris Christopherson. The people who come along like Chris Christopherson.
So
I'm
going
to play it up in position 3. Capo position 3. You must remember to put that into our book as 3.
Is that book 2?
No, this is in book 1, that's page 20. Oh, maybe it's in book 2. God, I don't know. We'll check at the end of this. There's a couple of key changes in this, so it'll be interesting to see where we get with this. Billy D was 7. So it's up on capo position 3. Billy D was 17 when he turned 21. Fooling with some foolish things he could have left alone. But he had to try to satisfy a thirst he couldn't name. Driven toward the darkness by the devil in his vein. All around the honky-tonk, searching for a sign. Getting high on getting high on women and words and wine. Some folks call him crazy, Lord, and others call him. Call us happy for the love of Billy D.
Change.
Busy going his own way and speaking his own word. Pacing and forgetting every warning that he heard. Making friends and taking any crazy chance he could. Getting busted for the bad times. Billy took a beating from a world he meant no harm. The score was written in the scars upon his arm. Some felt he was paying for the life he tried to lead. All we felt was sorry for our good friend Billy D. It may be his soul was bigger than our bodies of the day. Singing songs. Bringing laughter to the likes of you and me. Cause the world he saw was centered on the one he hoped to find. Wasn't near as lonesome as the one he left behind. Yesterday they found him on the floor of his hotel, reaching towards the needle arm that drove him down to hell. Some folks call it suicide and call it crucified when Billy D.O.D.
Oh, lovely, isn't it?
What book is that on? Sorry, I'm not sure what.
I don't know.
Oh yeah, it was in the second book.
Second book.
So what about I have another idea of Let Him Go, Let Him Tarry.
Yeah, but you know the one we must do tonight? The sun is burning in the sky.
The sun is burning. Where's that?
I don't know. We won't do it tonight. You know the Moore sing. It's beautiful. What do you call it?
I'm not sure. The sun is burning. What is it? What did I just say there? Let Him Go, Let Him Tarry. It's a nice one.
Wow. My goodness. Louis Brown says just left for a while, but Jackson Brown has tested positive for COVID-19. Mild symptoms.
Yeah, and our best wishes go out to everybody. God, it's an awful. It's a bit like, in Treasure Island when I was a kid, and you're reading Long John Silver, and he'd put this black thing in your hand, whatever it was, and once he put it in your hand, you know, that was you were done for or whatever. This is a bit like that, you know. God.
Anyway. Okay, well, let me see.
We just do what we can, I suppose.
So Paul said, great evening, Mary, Liam and Diego. Are we open?
I'm just going to see where. So, it's a bit of a nice rousing one before we finish
before
up
we
with parting glass.
Where are we putting that?
So we'll put it up in two and see how it goes.
Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He don't care for me. I don't care for him. He can go and get another. I hope she'll bring him joy. For I'm off to marry a far nicer boy. Fare thee well to cold winter. Now the summer's come at last. Nothing ever gained but my own true love I've lost. Sure I'd sing and I'll be happy with the birds upon a tree. Since he deceived me, I care no more for he. Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He doesn't care for me, nor I don't care for him. He can go and get another, and I'll hope she'll bring him joy. I'm off to marry a far nicer boy. Oh, he wrote me a letter saying he was very sent him back an answer saying, try him off. Oh, he wrote to me an author saying he was well and strong. I care no more for him than the ground he walks upon. Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He don't care for me or I don't care for him. He can go and get another and I'll hope she'll bring him. Some of his friends, they had a good kind wish for me. Others of his friends, sure they could hang me from a tree. Oh, soon I'll let them see my love, and soon I'll let them know that I can get a new sweetheart on any ground I go. Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He doesn't care for me, I don't care for him. Go and get another, and I'll hope she'll bring him joy. I'm off to marry a far nicer boy. He can go to his old mother now and set her mind at ease. She's a mean old woman, and she's very hard to please. For it's slightly and taken ill, is all she's ever done. Since I was courting her great big ugly son, let him go. Care for me, no,
I don't care for him.
He can go and get another, and I'll hope she'll bring him joy. I'm off to marry a far nicer boy.
Oh, my goodness.
That's a nice way to round off the evening, folks. Again, a lovely, lovely evening here in West Donegal, and I think it's a lovely evening in many parts of Ireland today.
Oh,
and hopefully in the rest of the world, people will be looking after each other and, I suppose, breathing deeply, breathe deep the gathering gloom from the Moody Blues.
Nancy said.
Nancy said.
sorry, go on, finish off.
No,
the
Nancy
boots.
Said.
I like
no,
the
we want
boots.
To hear what Nancy said.
Any, she said our connection is gone. Our internet connection is gone. We will say goodbye. Thank you. And Louis Brown says, Long John Silver is buried in my village graveyard in Suffolk.
Long John Silver. Who else did he say was there last week? There was somebody
else.
There
was a dog. Some kind of a black dog.
Oh, the black stick.
The black stick dog
or whatever. There was something else, Louis, I think you said was in Suffolk as well. Somebody else. Anyway, we're going to sing The Parting Glass, Capo 4. That's our...
nearly time for the news,
yeah,
I think.
So we're just getting into presenter mode and just see where we are. Yeah. So once again... Delighted to have spent the last couple of hours singing along with you. We hope you've enjoyed it. We hope you've joined in the songs, had some memories, maybe learned a few chords. Ray in Cooley, great man of sticking. And I think when all this is over, you'll be saying, wow, all these things that you know. I mean, we're shocked ourselves that we'd have, from complete bluffers and beginners, that we've now 500 songs. And if we were to do gigs every night and do 40 songs, we'd be in many nights... 40. No, 99. If we were doing 30 songs a night, we'd probably get away with about 21 nights before we'd have to...
get new books.
Yeah, go back to the...
Get
what is
book.
It, Kevin Starr says? Same,
go back to the beginning.
Same product, new markets, is it? Or new product, old markets, or something like that there. Anyway, good night.
Okay.
And thanks, everybody.
Thank you for being with us.
Okay. Of all the money that ever I spent, Capo 4, I've spent it in good cause. And all the harm that e'er I did, alas, it was to none but me. And all I have done for want of wit to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be. If I had money enough to spend, and leisure time to sit a while, there is a fair maid in the town that sorely has my heart beguiled. Her rosy cheeks and ruby lips, I own she has my heart enthralled. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you all. Of all the comrades that e'er I had, they're sorry for my going away. And all the sweet did wish me one more day to stay. Oh, but since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and softly call. Good night and joy be with you all. Good night and joy be with.
Thank you for being with us again.
So, again, until tomorrow evening, remember, if you haven't been here before, every evening at 7 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time or Dublin Time or London Time, Mary and I get together and do this live stream of what we call our Meitheal Ceol Daily Sing Song for the Soul, just a way of lifting the spirits and just removing us from all the other serious thoughts that we've no answers for anyway, that are going on all around us. Nice to have people, and most importantly, it's about you guys singing along with us and enjoying it and sharing your memories and your views and associations. So thanks everybody for being along with us tonight. Okay,
good night and God bless.